In this lecture, we are going to start with a new test design technique, that is state transaction testing techniques. So first, let's try to understand what is the meaning of it. State transaction testing is used to test the ability of the software to enter into and exit from defined states via valid and invalid transactions. So when we are performing a state transaction testing, our objective is to see how can we enter into some stage or how can we come out of the stage. And to do that, we have to perform a valid as well as a invalid transactions. To understand this point, let's move further. So what are we going to verify? We are going to verify different states. And when I say different states, that means valid or invalid states and valid and invalid transactions. What is the goal of state transaction testing? Obviously to test the valid states as well as invalid states. And the last one is, what is the significance? Why are we testing this valid states or invalid states? So that we can cover the sequence of states. So whatever sequence is defined in the requirement, that sequence we can test by using state transaction testing. Now let's see an example to understand this. Suppose you want to log in. When you are logging in, there are two states. First one is you can successfully log in and browse the data. Other one could be error message. But to achieve these two different states, you have to perform different actions or different events. If you perform a valid event, that means your user ID is correct and your password is correct, then you are able to browse the data. Whereas the other one could be invalid transaction. Your login is incorrect or your password is incorrect or both are incorrect. In that case, you will land in the error message. There could be one more state or one more event. When you are browsing the data, timeout happens. You are not doing anything. You are idle. In that case also, you may come out of the browser and that will also result in error message. So these are the different states and that is how you transit between these states. So from this example, we can have some analysis like events cause the software to transit from one state to the other state and perform different actions. So we were in the login state and our event is to provide the correct user ID as well as password. If that event is valid, then we enter into browsing data, and if that event is wrong, then we enter into error message. So that is what is the first point. Event causes the software to transact. So whenever any event happens, that forces the software to enter into different state. The next point is, event may be qualified by conditions which influences the transaction path to be taken. So sometime when event is negative or event is positive, that means valid or invalid, that will result in different conditions so that we take a different path. As we were in login data, if it is valid, it will take this path, the top path, and if the login details are wrong, then it will take the other path. So that is the condition they are talking about here. And with this, I'm ending this topic here and I will see you with the next one. Until then, happy testing.